And we're back. All the exciting evening we're looking forward to, with little Todd telling us his beautiful little lies. I'm sure we have magical events in store for everybody tuning in to watch. We'll be looking at the E3 Bethesda presentation. You can place your bets now on how disappointed you're going to be by the end of it. If you haven't written down suicidal, then you haven't watched a Bethesda E3 before. But we'll see how it turns out this year. I did a little bit of work in between the first stream where we had Microsoft up. Updated my report card. I don't know if you're keeping track with your own report cards on how you think E3 has been going. Let me throw it up there. See what chat thinks. See if you agree or disagree with my rating so far. Now we've got EA. I had my expectations and hopes listed. Went back and put the reality and the grade ranking for it. Reality turning out to be sports, 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 and of course, Battle Royale Lesbians with a big old F as a grade for Xbox. Very minimal amount of hype going into that one. A little bit more than EA, but not a lot more. Four good games, and Gears of War fans getting fucked. Now, I gave that a C. I got a lot of shit. People were saying, ah, it should have been a C plus, it should have been a B. But when I'm grading this, I'm looking at actual exclusives. Not just world-premiered multi-platform games. I want to see what Xbox is bringing. You know, if I'm going to go buy an Xbox, right? What's motivating me to do that? Well, it's not going to be the game that shows up on every other console. I'm looking for the shit that's exclusively for them. And sadly, there weren't a ton of them. And the ones they did show, like Gyno of War, not the best. Not the best. Not the best foot forward to put when you're doing a gaming convention. But nonetheless, it's fairly solid. It's middle of the road. It's a C. It's not an F. It's not an A. It's a C. It's not taking a shot at Microsoft. I mean, they did a competent presentation. Good amount of games, though they may have been a lot of multi-platform games. Not bad all around. So now we're looking at Bethesda. So what are my hopes? Elder Scrolls 6, probably never going to happen. Expectations, I have zero expectations. I've been around the block enough times to know what I'm dealing with when it comes to Bethesda. Hype level, a little bit more than EA, even a little bit more than Microsoft, just because good old Todd's going to be there. Our little guy's going to be there. Now, what the reality is going to be, what the final ranking is going to be, well, I'm going to have to wait. I'm going to have to wait for their live stream to find out, which will be starting for those wondering at half an hour past the hour. So 9:30 p.m. Eastern is when they officially start. So we've got about a half an hour to kill. So I figured answer a few questions, talk about a few things. Not sure how many of you are aware of this, but Atari is back. The Atari VCS home console system already raised $2.8 million with 10,707 backers. Fucking Atari. Now there's an article that came out saying they faked a lot of the shit in their trailers. Not a good start. But 2.8, that ain't bad. That's not a bad little start for that wooden console, and it does have a nice faux wood finish on the front of it. A lot of grills looking like the older consoles, the 2700 and so on. Now I'm not sure how well Skyrim's gonna run on this, but I'm pretty sure Todd's gonna at least try to put one on there. Maybe even some Fallouts. Use the old joystick and one button to maneuver around. The Ouya Touya, yeah, you could call it that. Except the Ouya raised, was it $8 million with 60,000 backers? So they've got a ways to go with their 19 days left. Yeah, no, chat, this is a real thing. This is a real thing they pitched. This is a real thing people have put money towards. They did show off Tempest 4000, which is an exclusive title for the system. So there's always that. If you're a big Tempest fan, well, you can drop $300 and buy yourself an Atari VCS. And then you can play all the indie games and multi-platform games that you just couldn't run on an Ouya, because this bad boy is at least 1.5 times more powerful. So that's always good. That's always a nice start. Jack Chalice, you like watching them waste their money, do you? I don't know if it's a waste of money. I mean, Atari's a legacy, isn't it? It's got a name brand recognition. How could you not want to put your money down on a restructured company that got bought by somebody else? I'm not saying that's a sign that there maybe you should reconsider giving them money. Clearly, the Atari VCS is the console of the fucking future. And you all just are being, you're just being negative Nellies. Just a bunch of naysayers for no reason. I don't understand all this fucking negativity. Fallout 2 and 4K, I mean, that is one way to do it. Right, just give me one moment here. I'm just checking the Bethesda stream. Nope, they're still showing off tweets. Actually. Now, I don't know how accurate this is, but they say if you tag your tweet with hashtag BE3, they'll put it up on screen. I don't know. I'm sure they've got some intern who's been stuck to deal with this. But maybe you could get something funny up on the fucking Bethesda stream because there's nothing else playing on it right now. It's a captive audience of like 25,000 people. And you could all call them retards for believing his sweet little lies. That's up to you. It's up to you. Never gone badly when a company uses a hashtag on a live stream. Always fucking works out brilliantly, let me tell you. You know, I have all these little images prepared, and I don't remember what half of them are. That's probably not good. Oh, there's the Atari one and the angry one. What is this one? I wonder what this one is. Oh, I'm sorry, that's a leak. That's a leak coming up for the Sony conference. I shouldn't be showing that right now. Sorry, you'll have to excuse that. That's for another day. That's for another day. Now, I don't know what your mission control center looks like for this Bethesda stream. I'd like to show you mine. Got my Todd room all ready to go. My former roommate's not around anymore. Tragic end. He believed in the feature set he was promised in Fallout 4 and he never really recovered from it. But I still keep the memory going. I have a little candle lit for him right next to my picture at Todd. Now maybe your room looks similar to this, and I swear to God, if you listen really closely on days like this on E3 streams for Bethesda, you can still hear my departed roommate. He's still there. If you listen, just listen really carefully, you can hear the specters wailing. Tragic. It's truly tragic. It's what happens when you believe Todd's little lies. But, you know, I'm ready. I hope you're all fucking ready. It's a Todd shrine. Come on. Don't act like you don't have one. We all have a Todd shrine. I can see you, chat. I can see you fucking talking shit about my Todd shrine. Maybe yours looks better. I don't have a high budget to work with. Just a lot of tape and blood red ink. And that's ink. You know, it's not blood or anything. Where's my little Todd? I've got a lot of little Todd pictures ready to go. I don't know if I'll get to use them all. But just little Todd pictures. Just things to remind us of what we're going to be dealing with once this fucking shit show proper starts. Look at that. Just don't believe his lies. But people do. Of course, if you don't believe his lies, he gets very angry, demanding that you buy his video games. Now, you know, we may all be sure that Bethesda games never turn out as promised, and that Todd lies his ass off to us constantly about the feature set and about what's available. But, you know, who do you think's laughing, huh? He got one up on us because every year we come back to watch it. And every fucking year we buy his video games.
Who's laughing now?
That's right. He got the last laugh. Fuck you, chat. Fuck all of us. Todd's on his A game. Okay. 25 minutes until the show begins. Oh boy. I really don't expect Elder Scrolls to be shown. Fallout 76, obviously, and I, you know, whatever else they end up showing us aside from Rage 2. Maybe it'll be good, maybe it'll be shit. You can never really tell. Skyrim Battle Royale? I don't know, chat. That might be going a little bit. That might be going a little bit overboard. I don't know if Bethesda's that far out in the thickets of not knowing what the fuck they're doing. Then again, I never would have guessed that we'd have a Battle Royale for fucking Battlefield either, but what do you know? And it looks like Halo might have one too. Because video games are just baneful. And God hates us all. So every game's getting a fucking Battle Royale. I'm sure Nintendo is going to have a Battle Royale game ready for our asses. Read a few of these signs here. Midran Emery's predictions. Fallout Mobile, Skyrim Tactics, more DLC, and Fallout 76. Everything you hate about Fallout 4, plus online. You're probably not wrong. That's probably a fairly accurate fucking prediction for what we're looking at. But you forgot paid mods. I saw more DLC, but no paid mods on there. Don't forget to put those in there. The Australian Patriarchy, day one DLC for Forza 4 will include Boogie2988's Hers. Vroom vroom, rip Boogie. Yeah, Boogie's dead, for those of you unaware. It's a tragic fucking passing. Lord Akira, Jimbo, Microsoft won the battle t or with Battletoads. Get over it. Well, I do admit Battletoads is great, but I'm gonna need a little bit more. I can't. Well, I mean, maybe the Xbox One X could become the Battletoad system, like PlayStation 4 is the Bloodborne system. It's a possibility. Zemeckis Lebowski, sup nerd, doing my own E3 shit. But I'll rewatch all this later. Enjoy Todd Howard's supple body and his sweet little eyes. Goodbye, boy. Nemesis Raccoon, West Virginia, take me home. I think we're all going to want to go home after this press conference finishes. Nick Korvik, oh goody, we're all in for Fallout 4 LARP harder. I'm sure we are. Genoa, ready to go in on the. I know these are fucking joke comments, but the truth is, everything that you're throwing out there as a punchline is probably going to be a fucking reality by the end of today. Genoa, ready to go on the paid mods roller coaster again, Jim. Also, what do you think of Rage 2, if anything? I have no opinion on Rage 2. All I remember about Rage was that it was a bitch to get to run on the PC, that it was glitchy and the textures were fucked up and just a nightmare. Didn't really matter what kind of configuration you were running it with. Hank Wimbledon 76 release will be in July to get ahead of Red Dead. Well, hopefully they're not rushing it out the door. But why would Bethesda ever do that? Why would Bethesda ever release a product that's not ready to go? Sir Blast, did you know that ass cancer is caused by sitting in a chair with traces of lead in them? No, neither does Total Biscuit. Oh, Sir Blast, did you read that comment on Adam Sessler's Twitter feed? I saw what he posted earlier. Just terrible. Evil Homer 101 chat, I'm leading the right wing death squads out tonight if the presentation is as disappointing as we know it will be. Apparently, there's going to be blood in the streets. James Russell, Country Roads, take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, Mountain Mama, take me home, Country Roads. Onitama, incoming Funko Pops Skyrim Battle Royale, buy his game Goyim. Yeah, that wouldn't have been so much of a joke if we didn't just look at Gears of War Pop Edition. Fucking not just that. Gears of War Pop Edition Mobile. Followed by fucking Gears of War Tactics. Followed by Gears of War The Estrogen Saga. Starring Little Miss Me. So you say that as a joke, but we'll see what happens. Joe Bro, pitch non-existent product, become a made man. Lord Akira, can't wait for the Crobat video on the Ouya Touya Electric Boogaloo. I don't know what's going to happen with the Atari VCS. I think it's about a year away from coming out, regardless of how much money they raise. So if it even gets to that point, but yeah, I'd imagine there's going to be an entertaining video about it. Nemesis Raccoon, ever played a Super Robot Wars game to fulfill your love of weeb fan fiction? Yes, I've played those before, but not in a long fucking time. I think the last one was PlayStation 2? YouTube official, I need you to call my friend Riley Paul Woods a tran, a tran, a tranny fucker. I don't think you need to spell it differently. I don't think YouTube cares. God Howard, nice to see another fan on the internet. Elder Scrolls 9 is on the way. Tavid Andros, Jimbo is my favorite race mixer. Now, don't believe God Howard. Elder Scrolls 9 is not directly on the way. At least not until you get through the paywall and buy the DLC for Fallout 4. Or Fallout 76 now, I don't know. He's going to fucking sell as much DLC as he can. Elizabeth Bathory, screencap this Doom Battle Royale. I don't know, chat. What do you think we're going to get a bomb here? Do you think they're going to drop Doom 2 and it's going to be some fucked up online multiplayer shit? How angry would you be? How absolutely fucking pissed off would you be if that was true? Joachim Hotch, Skyrim Battle Royale for Temple OS. We can dream. It's got that 16 colors. That's how God intended it. Joe Bro, this is Todd Howard. Have you purchased Skyrim? You're not going to trick me. I'm not going to buy it for the 18th time on the 19th system. James Russell, see those Blue Ridge Mountains? You can climb them. I expect a line like that to be uttered by him at least once tonight. Leo Ways, why isn't that failure cuck Purple Bad Dragon Worski streaming this? Even Ralph is getting in on the E3 madness. Also, Metaporn Plexstorm win. Thanks, Jim. I have no idea why Andy wouldn't be streaming this. He does have a gaming channel called Purple Dragon. As far as Ralph, maybe he's streaming too. I don't know. Filthy Animal, Roblox Battle Royale. Please stop with the Battle Royales. Roadkill Phil, can't wait for Fallout 76. Four times as big as Fallout 4. For half the RPG. Yeah, he did say at the Microsoft press conference that it was going to be four times the size of Fallout 4. So, four times the emptiness. Four times the lack of NPCs. Four times the need to use quick travel. Four times the wondering to yourself while you've wandered for 20 minutes, why did I buy this game in the first place? Four times all of that. Politically incorrect. Jim, do you still identify as a trans nigger? Yes, I do. Don't judge me. Myself and Rachel Dizelle, is that her name? We're living the life. The stiff eye lens, can't wait for Session. Fuck EA for not making Skate 4. Yeah, I was actually really surprised when I saw the video pop up. I swear to God, I thought that was Skate 4. It's not, it's Session, which is either a rebranding or a real subtle way of just stealing it. I don't know. The Job Low Show. Can't wait for Todd to pitch the hottest new game fad, Chemical Castration. Skyrim for N64, really working to get those ports out. Edmund Poppy, on one of those few tweets has a degenerate fur fag, ugh. Literally a nobody, almost heaven, Todd's a liar. See that mountain? He said I could climb it. The engine's old now, older than Fallout, younger than Bethesda. I don't know, when I saw the 76 trailer during the Microsoft conference, it didn't look bad. It looked okay, but I don't know what they're going to do with it. And I don't know how they're going to make base building more doable in this version than they could in the last one without some kind of weird memory issues. And it's probably going to be like some kind of mind fuck like Skyrim on PlayStation 3 was, where all your shit gets corrupted the moment you start doing something. Incel Casanova, please announce the GoFundMe to remove walls to transport Boogie to the morgue. I will make sure to update you on that. And finally, Jet Set Tomato. Looking forward to New Vegas fags bitching how it's just not the same. We are officially 15 minutes away. 15 minutes away from Bethesda's showing. Oh, it's getting exciting. I hope you can feel it in the air. I'm looking at the hashtags that are up there. You know what? I'm going to throw it up right now. I'm going to let you all take a look. Let's see what they've got. Now, I'm not saying that you should go to Twitter right now and tweet out horrific things with the hashtag BE3. That would be irresponsible of me, and I would never, ever suggest to do that. But if you were to do that, chances are it's going to show up on the stream that Bethesda's doing at this very moment. It's a possibility. Unless, of course, Todd has lied to us once again. And this is all just pre-made, pre-roll bullshit. And it's not taking live tweets at all. I mean, you could probably confirm that by going to look at the accounts they're listing and seeing how long ago these were tweeted. But I don't see any dicks yet on the screen. I don't see any decapitated babies, or cats being set on fire, or piles of drugs, or just horrific shit that you would expect people on Twitter would be bombarding them with at this very fucking moment. Somebody in chat suggesting this is subliminal messaging. If you arrange all the tweets they're putting up, it's telling you to buy Skyrim. Very well could be. This is some kind of a trick. A trick to get us to buy shit once again from Todd. Ingenious son of a bitch. Yeah, I'm still not seeing anything horrific. I think they might be making this up. I don't think this is actually live from a feed that's using this hashtag. We'll see later. If I see any cocks pop up, I'll be sure to check back in on that. Somebody in chat said, it's not live, it's a 7-hour delay. Holy shit. Oh. Well, even 7 hours ago, you would expect somebody would have put something up just monumentally offensive. I've got to up my game, I think. I've got to really start thinking ahead for 2019. And I'm just going to sit on the BE3 hashtag and just wait for next year. In fact, if I start bombarding it right now, by the time next year rolls around, I'll have all the tweets that get shown on screen. I could compose an entire story about how Todd Howard killed and ate his mother, and people will be regaled with that while they're waiting for the Bethesda show to start at next year's E3. A few more comments coming through here. All right, read some of these before we get going. We got about 14 minutes left before the show proper starts. Oh, where are we here? Principal Barra, will Boogie's funeral be hosted at E3? Well, somebody said he's going to actually be at the Sony conference or before the Sony conference talking to NBA players. Now, they could have been just pulling my leg, but I have to watch it if it's true. Because I could have sworn there was a story that floated around that Boogie shit himself at some convention he went to. And like there was a trail of liquid shit under him as he was riding his little scooter around. And somebody had to tell him he made a boom boom. I don't know if that's true or not, but if you're telling me some dude's going to be talking to people in front of a bunch of press and an audience and a live stream audience, and there's a possibility he could shit himself, I'm going to watch it. I'm going to watch the fuck out of that. Nuke the ice caps. Can't wait for Skyrim cart. I think we're all waiting for it. Psychic Trout. Skyrim on McDonald's order kiosks. Of course, why not? Power Cage. When are we getting Jim versus Dino Dino version 2.0? For anybody listening unfamiliar, Dino Dino or Dino Dina, whatever the fuck his name is, was a video game developer, worked on a lot of older games that were actually pretty highly acclaimed. Mostly sports titles, I think soccer titles, especially in Europe. There's never going to be a rematch. Especially considering that when we argued on live stream, and I pressured him to tell me who was responsible for shitty games getting pushed out that fuck over customers, he said the publishers were responsible for that. And within about 30 seconds of him saying that, he gets a phone call from his publisher and has to leave the room for like 5 minutes. So I think he probably got yelled at, and I don't think we're ever going to have another discussion. Midran Emery's, Gears of War 5, my vajayjay edition with 100% more estrogen. Yes, that's kind of the vibe people are getting from it. Oofen, what's your favorite re-release of Skyrim? Well, it's going to be Skyrim on the... Texas Instruments calculator. I mean, what can't you play Skyrim on? /Halen, what are the odds we go back to Bethesda Land this year? Think there will be any expansion to the park? I don't know if they're going to go with the same presentation. They might try it. We're going to find out in 10 minutes. Slug to the chest. E3 is an inside job from the glow-in-the-dark CIA naggers. Fuck Liberalist says, Sargon is a faggot. Just a daily reminder. Dog Fox Hybrid, Moonman Doom, best game. Sam McCleary, see those mountains? You can pay for them 5 times over for the next 3 years. I see that you've studied the same business school that Todd Howard went to. That's how he's, I suppose it's unfair Bethesda gets a bad rap because they put their fucking games on everything that exists under the sun. But I think the thing that really bothers people, and bothers me, well, it's two things, really. It's that they fuck with the modding... Well, it's three things. They fuck with the modding community and do their paywall bullshit. They push out buggy games that they expect other people to fix. And again, by fucking with the modding community, that's going to make that a more bizarre situation. And I don't like Pete Hines. I've never really DC Deacon, whatever he goes by on Twitter, never liked him. Kind of a dick to the customers. Midran Emery's, Jim, if you identify as transracial, Sean, Talcum X King will get you for gimmick infringement. Be careful. Duly noted, Midran. Epic Fiddle Guy, Fallout 76 plot. You're in a vault where the experiment is to force thousands of people to play a video game at gunpoint. Skyrim on Robco Terminal. It's very meta. Pelagus Lobo, Skyrim on sticks and dirt when? We're going to find out pretty fucking soon. Timu Jatu, tell me lies, make me bust a nut 76 times. Terry Leftovers, please give me all tonight's super chats, Jim. I'm afraid I can't do that, Terry. I need all of them to buy at least 182 copies of Skyrim that Todd is going to sell me in about 10 minutes. Ghetto Tarzan Fallout 76 Farmville Edition, hours of tree chopping. I see too in chat people are asking. Last couple of years I've done E3, I've usually played Honey Pop. Just because there was such a big break between the Microsoft and the Bethesda one, I decided to go have dinner instead. Tomorrow it's not going to be two separate streams, it's just one stream the whole day through. So I'm going to be playing a game in between each of the streams, because there's about a half an hour to an hour break in between each one. Like tomorrow is much more structured than today was, or the first day of E3 with just EA was. I mean, you've got four presentations that are just kind of one after the other, which is great. That's kind of what you want. I guess it builds up hype or keeps interest. I don't know what the fuck they're doing this year. It's really bizarre. Soul Blazer, when is the next Deviance episode, Jim? Not for a while. Blue Satoshi, tweet Fleetwood Mac to BE3. Cool ROM man, how much of the game do you think will be included with Fallout 76? I'm betting we could get like 25% of the game. I really don't know. He's saying it's four times as big, all these new features. People are speculating there's a large online component that's been talked about by different journalists at different outlets, and just people that say they have inside information or are leaking it. We're going to find out. There's no purpose, I guess, in speculating at this point. We're going to find out in like 10 minutes. Silvec Inc. Doom 2 Hell Online. At least if that happens, we get more awful acted out party chat. Soon enough, they'll make a Battle Royale game about the movie Battle Royale. You know what? Somebody trademarked that. Silvec Inc., you might be joking, but I could almost imagine a Japanese company deciding to make a Battle Royale game about the movie Battle Royale. I mean, it makes sense, doesn't it? It's the fucking namesake. Why wouldn't they do it? Tumbling Pebble just wants to say dicks. Well, there you go. Viking, any sighting of Tariq Nasheed at E3? I don't believe so. I think he's just trolling people online like he does on a daily basis. Filthy Animal, Trudeau eyebrows, though. Trudeau's eyebrows thoughts. I have no thoughts on Trudeau's eyebrows. I don't really pay attention to Canadian politicians all that much. I just like to make fun of him because he's an idiot on social media. Elderly queer gentleman, somebody has been sifting through Bix and swastikas for 7 hours to roll a Twitter reel between actual footage. That was someone's job today. Huh. That's very true. Somebody did get paid to make sure they sanitize the feed that's now playing for the Bethesda audience. Nate Civil, but don't you love the devs? I don't love any devs, to be honest with you. There are devs that I like, people that have put out consistently good stuff, but I've never really been much of a fanboy as far as developers go. James Russell, what are the chances Donald Trump is in Fallout 76? There might be high chances. People thought he was going to be in Division too. They're going to go deal with those big bad politicians in Washington. Teach him a lesson. The Red Devil can't wait for Skyrim board game. I think you should wait. The narrator, the Ralph Retort is stream sniping you. Shake my head, ask Zidane. Well, hello to the Ralph Retort viewers. I hope you're all ready to be lied to by Todd, because that's what's going to happen to all of us. Alan O'Reilly, gas the boogie, wait war now, and politically incorrect, it's a giant hoax just like the Holocaust. All right, we are moments away from the start of Eve. Oh, we got a pre-roll show going. I'm going to shut the fuck up. Let's get this going.
That's not all. Call right now and you'll also receive a brand spanking new gameplay trailer for Rage 2.
And what's that number to call?
1-800, I really hadn't thought this far ahead. Roll the gameplay anyway.
When the asteroid hit,
Oh boy, we got wubs.
Billions were gone in the blink of an
dubstep
eye.
Dubstep apocalypse, here we go.
Tribes rose up. Alliances formed. Territory was conquered. There was no one left alive to tell you no. And in this wild, wide open place, if you wanted something bad enough, it was yours for the taking. You see, in a world where there are no rules, insanity rules.
Mutants, neon, explosions. What more could a person ask for in life?
Honestly, nothing. Food? Unnecessary.
Oh,
sleep?
God.
No way. Shelter? Not unless it's Fallout Shelter. Download today.
You went a really long way for a little wordplay.
Worth it.
But Bethesda really does provide our communities with pretty much everything they could ever ask for, which must be why we have such incredible and dedicated fans.
I love Bethesda fans. Those folks out there are ready to party.
They buy all your shit.
Are.
I bet you I
and
love them a lot.
There's definitely a few Fallout fans out there, which is great, because we just announced something very exciting.
Now, Anne.
Now, Abigail.
Yes! Just a few short weeks ago, we released a teaser for Fallout 76. I am seriously so excited about this one.
Is this the actual show or is this the pre-show?
We may have already teased it, but tonight we are going all out. We have so much to say when it comes to Fallout 76, and I really can't wait to see what people think. Let's roll that announced teaser one more time before we finally let you guys get to the showcase you're all waiting for.
Oh yeah, we've all seen this before. I'll let it play, but I'm gonna mute it. We'll let that play in the background. Alright, that was the pre-show. I got a little worried there for a second. I thought Todd put a wig on and some problem glasses and was trying to LARP as a woman to sell me Skyrim again. I got a little unnerved by that, but I think we're okay. We are 4 minutes. No, not even 4 minutes. Fuck me, I can't read a clock. We are 2 minutes away from the start of Bethesda's E3 show. They're just re-showing the Fallout 76 trailer we've seen a few times already. Chat, what are you thinking? Let's say on a scale of 1 to 5, 1 being you're going to drink bleach at the end of this, and 5 being you're going to go tell your friends to buy a copy of Skyrim. What do you think? How do you think this is going to turn out? What do you think the Bethesda stream is going to be like? 1 awful, 5 excellent. I don't have a lot of hope for this. I'm going to put out a 2. I've got a tiny bit of hope that maybe there'll be something surprising, but not a lot, just a 2. People saying check live. Am I behind? I might be behind here. I'm behind.
And what do you think we're going to be learning about Fallout 76 tonight?
I don't think we need to speculate, because the showcase is just about to start. That's right. It's finally time for us to say goodbye to you and let you get to the showcase you have all been waiting.
Somebody in chat actually voted for.
Thank you so much.
I'm almost certain that guy is Todd Howard's alternate account.
The 2018 BE3 Showcase pre-show. Remember to use that BE3 hashtag to talk about the show and let us know what you think.
Oh yeah, be sure to let him know. Be sure to let him know with brutal honesty what you think. Special.
There's a brand new Twitch extension featuring trivia and polls that could get you a free Twitch drop. Just link your BethesdaNet account to your Twitch account and load up the extension and you'll be eligible for the drop. Yay, free stuff!
Yay! And that's it for us. Once again, I'm Ann Lewis.
And I'm Abigail Tyson. Enjoy the show!
Bye!
Bye! Ugh.
All right, here we go. Video games. Here we go. The fucking video games are beginning. Oh god, it's a countdown timer. I'm so excited. I'm gonna get to see a new deluxe edition of Skyrim, a new deluxe edition of Fallout 4, and maybe a re-release of Morrowind. Oh boy. Some Rage 2 footage, which you'll be sure won't run on your fucking computer because it'll be just like Rage 1.
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's
Bethesda, all right. The mom goes to work and dad stays home cooking for the kids. That's the mental image I had of this company.
We come from different backgrounds. From different countries. We have different interests. And different points of view. We aren't all developers. But it takes all of us. Every one of us to make these games. A job we take very seriously. We try and break things.
God, this feels like a life insurance commercial.
We keep the teams happy and fed. We keep our fans happy and on the edge of their seats. We keep the books balanced, discover new talent, and interact with our community. Most of all, we work together as old friends and new. What unites us is our passion for games. Games as diverse as the people who make them.
Diversity is our strength. There it is again. That's three conferences that said it.
We're not just living the dream. We're creating it. We are all. Bethesda Softworks, how may I direct your call?
Mm-hmm.
You can start the show. Please welcome Bethesda's Global Senior Vice President, Pete Hines.
Oh, they would start it with him.
Thank you.
Hey, everybody, look, it's the
Thank
last white male at
much.
Bethesda.
You sound good. I love you, too. You look good. You guys ready to go? As Paula said, my name is Pete Hines, and I'm delighted to be back on stage for Bethesda's fourth annual E3 Showcase. Now, we've got all kinds of surprises in store for you tonight, so whether you're here with us in the audience or you're one of the millions who are watching around the world, settle in, get ready for the very best in gaming. Our theme this year is Create, and it's a theme embraced by our 10 studios spread around the globe, the incredibly talented folks who make the Bethesda games that you'll soon be playing. But as you saw in our intro video, it's not just developers. Everyone at Bethesda is a part of the team that brings our games to life, and that extends to all of you, because we create the worlds, but You create your own adventures, stories, and experiences, and it's your passion for games that drives us every day to strive for excellence. The past year has been an exciting one for Bethesda as we released some of the best games of 2017. Games like Prey, Dishonored: Death of the Outsider, The Evil Within 2, Wolfenstein 2.
I think that's pre-roll. I don't see the audience reacting.
Updates for The Elder Scrolls Online.
That's a soundbox. That's not a real audience. Look at them. They're all dead.
Full open world VR with Fallout 4 and Skyrim plus Doom VFR. And we even released.
Look at the audience isn't doing anything.
The Nintendo Switch.
That's fake applause and clapping. Look at the audience.
So
they're
we were
not
thrilled
doing shit.
When Metacritic named us the top publisher in the industry with the highest overall review scores across all of our games.
Hey, they got four people clapping.
But
probably
tonight
Bethesda
is about
employees.
The future. We're here to show you where we're headed and the games that we're creating that you'll soon be playing, the worlds that you'll be inhabiting in the next year and beyond. So, we're starting with a game that we announced a few weeks ago through our friends at Walmart Canada. Perhaps best known for their low prices and ability to keep a secret. So let's get things started with a look at Rage 2.
Here we go. See how this one turned out. It looks like it'd be, you know, maybe okay. I just want the fucking thing to run. That's all I'm asking for. What the fuck is this?
All right!
Is that Andrew WK?
My name's Andrew WK!
I answered my question.
Are you ready to rage? I said, are you ready to rage?
And here's your gameplay, a live musical performance from Andrew WK.
Are you ready to rage? Let's have some fun!
The audience's face. They look so confused. They're like, where are the video games? This isn't Rage 2. What the fuck is this? I thought you were getting gameplay, did ya?
Who's laughing now?
Yeah. gameplay, ladies and gentlemen. Rage 2 gameplay.
Let's give it up again for Andrew WK, the perfect song for Rage 2. Hi, everyone. My name is Tim Willits, and I am the studio director at id Software.
And I'm Magnus Nedfors, game director at Avalanche Studios.
And we're here to say that Rage is back.
The game nobody asked for is back once again.
We had crazy ideas when we started planning Rage 2. And we needed the right studio to bring our vision to life. Now, we've admired the open world chaos in all of Avalanche Studios games. And as we're about to show you, they delivered big time.
This is pretty awful. This is off to a very bad start.
Well, thank you, Tim.
Show the fucking gameplay already! Yeah. Jesus Christ! I don't need your musical acts and your shitty stand-up comedy. Show the fucking game!
Well, speaking for everyone at Avalanche Studios, this is really a dream to come true for us. The world of Rage 2 is perfect for our style of gameplay. But even more exciting than that has been to work with these guys at id Software. These guys invented the first-person shooter. And they still make the best shooters out there. So it's been a really great collaboration to bring you the most insane open world shooter you have ever played.
So Rage 2 transports players into a dystopian future devoid of society, law, and order. Now you play as Walker, the last ranger of the wasteland. Now, you know, I can talk all night about our guns, the powers you'll use, the vehicle combat, and of course, you know, the crazy open world. But I know that you are here to see the game. Well, not only do we have Rage 2 playable at our booth at E3, but we've got for you an extended look at the world and gameplay of Rage 2. Let's check it out right now.
Yeah.
Yeah, right now. Only took 15 minutes. Great.
Asteroid on a collision course with Earth. Global extinction event.
80% of the Earth's population dead.
God turned his back on humanity long ago. It wasn't a war. It wasn't global warming. It was a fucking asteroid. I was born in this shithole. Parents murdered. An orphan of this wasteland. An army of mutants killed everyone I ever loved. All that's left is hate, fear, and the need for survival. You see, part of growing up was watching everything get taken from me. I stood by, did nothing. And now, I'm the last ranger of this wasteland. And there's only one thing left to do!
That's it? Okay.
Hello, E3, and welcome to the world of Rage 2. In a moment, we'll dive headfirst into the Eden spaceport mission, where Walker, our main protagonist, is out to find a rare artifact that will aid him in his quest to take down the Authority.
Doctor, I'm approaching the Eden Space Center.
Ah, yes, I forgot to say. It might be overrun by bandits. the Goon Squad, to be precise. You must like
it. It looks good. I can't deny it. It looks good.
Pulling down the eco pod from orbit and securing the untainted nanotrites therein.
How much you want to bet it won't look anything like this when it hits stores? You're wrong, chat, when you say the colors are terrible. These are the most beautiful browns I've ever seen.
Doctor, you made it to the Space Center.
Keep your wits about you, Walker. The Goon Squad may look whimsical.
It's like a post-apocalyptic tumbler. Everybody's got the haircut.
They are very, very dangerous.
I mean, who figures an asteroid crashes into Earth, but there's plenty of hair dye left, huh? Wipes out civilization centers, but at least the pharmacy's still got that hair dye.
Sensor activated. Is the rocket the crusher talking acting? And it can be yours wild and black. Rage.
Procedure for Eco 15, still in orbit.
Recall sequence approved. Beginning EcoPod recall. The EcoPod has landed
down.
Without incident.
The EcoPod made it.
I know, and so does the authority. Hurry, get the untainted nanotrites and get out. Also for you, there is an extra boon. Something that will make you a veritable superhero.
Elevator's still running? So far, so good. Looks like Ranger Walker's gonna get a bit of a boost today.
I can't believe all the people in chat saying this is bullshittery. This is completely real, legitimate gameplay, and will totally look like this on your Xbox. See a lot of people comparing it to Bulletstorm without the point system. It does have that vibe, doesn't it?
From Bethesda Softworks, Christian Van Hoos.
How's it going, everybody? I'm Christian Van Hoos, community manager for the Elder Scrolls Legends. For the past year, we've taken what I think is the best digital card game and made it even better. New cards, new modes, new ways to play, and much more. But we wanted to push ourselves even further. So tonight, I'm thrilled to announce that we will soon be relaunching the Elder Scrolls Legends with brand new, totally overhauled visuals. I'm also very excited to let you all know that Legends will be available later this year on Nintendo Switch, Xbox One, and PlayStation 4. But there's no reason to wait to play the game that Apple awarded Best of the Year in 2017. Download The Elder Scrolls Legends for free and join me tonight on PC, mobile, or tablet. And any progress you make in the game will be carried over to the console versions through your BethesdaNet account.
They don't even know what they're clapping for.
And now, let's take a look at the future of Legends and see why this isn't just my favorite card
game. Let's not.
But will soon be yours as well.
Let's not and say we did.
It starts small. One game is all it takes. But Legends never stay simple. Never stay small. This is action. This is story. This is competition. This is easy to pick up. This is hard to put down.
That's all the money from the loot boxes they made.
This is a 5-minute train ride. This is a 5-hour marathon. This is for any way you play. This is for anywhere you play. This is for strategy fans. This is for those who want magic at their fingertips. This is for those who want dragons at their command. This is a game where legends are born. This is for you.
From ZeniMax Online Studios, Matt Firer.
Well, looks like we got some Elder Scrolls Online shit coming up.
Thanks, everyone. I'm Matt Firer. I'm the game director on the Elder Scrolls Online. thank you. Before I get started tonight, I just want to do a shout-out. It was really great we started the showcase tonight with a video highlighting the really talented people that work behind the scenes to make all of these great games possible. So standing here on stage, I'm representing a whole lot of amazing people at ZeniMax Online Studios that I go to work with every day. It's a great honor and privilege. So I go to work with them every day, but at night, I go home, log into Elder Scrolls Online, and I get to play games with you guys, the best gaming community in online gaming. We are such big fans of what we do. We play the games just as, you know, we make them, and we play them just as much as you guys do. It's what we do. You know, so you might not know it, but
God, this is
we're
so
right
boring.
There alongside.
No wonder
I'm playing
Todd
there
didn't
with
show
you.
Up.
I'm running dungeons. I'm exploring Tamriel, questing, crafting, decorating my house, PvPing, stabbing. Yeah, that was me. And I'm really humbled to say that the Elder Scrolls Online community just keeps getting bigger. We're over 11 million players now. And over 1 million of those came in just the last year alone. So last year was really great for us in a whole lot of ways. We were named MMO of the Year for the third straight year. We released Morrowind. A lot of great DLC, and just last week we released Somerset, the latest chapter in the Elder Scrolls Online.
That fucking applause sign is going to burn out if they keep turning it on.
It's been you know, received with great critical acclaim. Everyone loves it. You get to travel to the island home of the High Elves for the first time in 20 years. It's great for new players. If in the off chance you aren't playing Elder Scrolls Online, this is a great chance to jump in and play. And of course, all you veteran ESO fans are already there. But we're not done there. We make DLC every quarter for chapters. You know, content comes out so regularly for Elder Scrolls Online. We're already working on our great plans for next year. But before that, the next DLC coming out is a dungeon DLC named Wolf Hunter, based on werewolves.
No shit. What do you think it was going to be based on? Reptiles, dipshits? It's called Wolf Hunter.
And later this year, we have a story DLC named Murkmire. We're going back to Black Marsh. So you guys have all been asking for a deeper dive into Argonian lore and culture. You're going to see it later this year.
Listen to him breathing. He's super nervous.
So there's one theme that runs through all of the Elder Scrolls Online's content, and that is great storytelling. From the launch game through all the DLC and chapters, it's really, really what holds the game together. But it's not just the stories that we as developers create for you guys to experience. It's also the stories that you create together when you play this great virtual world. So I'm going to leave you tonight with a video highlighting just some of the amazing stories and memorable characters that you'll meet on your ESO journey. Thanks, everyone. See you in Tamriel.
God, the audience looks like they're going to fall asleep. They feel like I do right now. I'm so incredibly fucking bored. Oh, this is not a good fucking E3 show from them. Oh, this is making EA start to look okay. I think Todd Howard fucked with us. I don't think he's showing up. This has been a giant bait and switch. That is the most low energy clapping I've ever fucking heard. Holy shit. Fuck yeah, finally. Finally something good.
Thank you. Thanks so much. I'm Marty Stratton, executive producer of Doom Eternal.
And I'm Hugo Martin, creative director on Doom Eternal.
In 2016, we launched our reboot of Doom and have been blown away by your support and excitement for the game. Thank you. In fact, it's a combination of your passion and our team's love of making Doom that has motivated us to deliver even more.
So we're back to announce Doom Eternal. An awesome, awesome new sequel to Doom. For the past 2 years, it's been so inspiring to hear you guys talk about what you'd like to see next. And I gotta tell you, we're right there with you. Like, you want the Doom Slayer to feel even more powerful? Well, we got it. You want even more badass demons? Well, there are twice as many in this game. You want to see hell on earth? Well, we just teased it. But what we're most excited about is to show you some of the things that you might not be expecting.
That's right, including a ton of features that we'll have to save for later because our team will be debuting Doom Eternal at QuakeCon this August. We'd love for you to join us live in Dallas, or of course you can tune in online to catch all the fun. But until then, we want to thank everyone who continues to play Doom.
Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.
How's everybody feeling tonight? Pretty hype? Just like a little hype or like crazy hype right now, right? Let's go.
They're dead on the inside. Hi.
I'm Joshua Boyle, community manager for Quake Champions. Thank you very much. Ever since the first Quake title was released in 1996, our games have been shaped by you, the players. Now, that proud tradition continues with Quake Champions, which has evolved with community in mind and will always be the fastest and most fun multiplayer shooter, period. And that's not the only tradition that Quake's continuing. These days, we're hearing a lot of talk about esports, but Quake has been there from the very beginning. In fact, we started hosting competitions at QuakeCon over 20 years ago. It's here for QuakeCon.
And look at the audience in the background. They're not doing anything.
On our legacy as the original esport, with everything from intense grassroots competitions to major tournaments at QuakeCon and DreamHack Winter. We've been doing this for a long time, and we're continuing to build with more competitions for more players than ever before. But I gotta tell you guys, we can't stop, won't stop until we've delivered a game that's fun for everyone. Whether you're a Quake dad or a brand new baby to the arena. That's why we just added a bunch of new features to make it even easier for you and your friends to jump in and get good together. We're still in early access, but tonight we want to welcome all of you into the arena. For this week only, we're opening up Quake Champions to everyone through a trial of our free-to-play version before it even launches. Plus, if you get in and download this week, you can stay and keep playing Quake Champions for free even after the trial closes. So head to Quake.com and start playing with me and all of my Quake family tonight.
Don't miss your chance to join one of the most passionate and welcoming communities in gaming. Now, for a taste of what you'll be playing tonight after our showcase is over, check out our new trailer for Quake Champions.
We'll find out how tasty soon.
The bigger the guns, the bigger the boom.
E3 from all of us at Arkane Studios here in Austin, Texas. It's been 1 year since we launched Prey, and we want to send a big thanks to our incredible fan base for your support.
We've been so inspired by your passion and enthusiasm, and as a way of showing our appreciation, we're rolling out a huge free update for Prey tonight.
The next time you fire up Prey, you're going to see three new modes: Story Mode, New Game Plus,
which was a big fan request,
and Survival Mode, which should be an interesting challenge for our most hardcore fans.
But that's just the beginning. We are really excited to tell everyone that we've also been working on a new Prey DLC, an infinitely replayable experience called Moon Crash.
It's a new twist on Prey where the enemies, hazards, and loot are all different each time you play.
We're so excited. We can't wait to
is a harsh mistress. The longer you're here, the harder things are going to get for you. Let's get to work.
I legit loved Prey, so I'm actually looking forward to this. How sad is that? I'm gonna buy their DLC.
Let's get to work. Let's get to work.
Warning, flooding and electrical damage detected. Warning, lethal radiation levels detected.
Are you all clapping, chat? Are you clapping for the DLC? You should be.
All right, before we begin, yes, Mom, I'm still alive. No, I'm not a mimic.
Hang on. There. I just want to make sure nobody tries to smack you because I saw Pete Hines with a wrench backstage a second ago.
Thank you, Ricardo. That's very sweet of you. So, like all arcade games, Prey is about playing your own way, and Mooncrash is no exception.
So you just saw a lot of cool stuff that's available tonight, but we're not done yet. We have one more surprise coming later this summer called Typhon Hunter.
Typhon Hunter is a lethal game of hide and seek, where one player goes head to head against five other players who get to be mimics.
And just like in Prey, the mimic players can disguise themselves as everyday objects. So, you know, things like a chair, a coffee mug, a space banana, whatever works. But definitely not a coworker, right, Susan?
Absolutely not. Probably not.
No!
Anyway, Typhon Hunter is a tense multiplayer mode that requires teamwork and improvisation and a very high tolerance for jump scares.
Before we go, I just want to say thanks on behalf of the whole team at Arkane Studios to all of our fans around the world who have played Prey and love it. We made this game for you, and we are constantly inspired by your creativity and enthusiasm.
Thank you so much, everyone.
Please welcome Jens Matthies and Jurk Gustafsson.
Hello, friends. I'm Jens Matthies, the creative director at Machine Games.
And I'm Jurk Gustafsson, executive producer at Machine Games.
Last year, millions of you took to the streets and sparked a revolution in Wolfenstein 2, The New Colossus. As BJ Blazkowicz, you rallied the American resistance and you beat the living fuck out of those Nazis.
Thank you for embracing our game. We were honored to win Best Action Game at the Game Awards last December. And we are excited to bring Wolfenstein 2 to Nintendo Switch on June 29th so you can fight the Nazis on the go.
And the Wolfenstein revolution continues with our next project, which leaps ahead in time to tell the tale of BJ's twin daughters.
Of course. Oh, Jesus Except Christ.
In the 1980s in Paris, Wolfenstein Youngblood pushes the story forward.
And because this game features BJ's twin daughters, Wolfenstein Youngblood will be a co-op experience. So, while you can play it solo, you can also join with a friend to save the world together. The Resistance is counting on you.
Yeah. All right, Hollyboss, let's check it out.
Wolfenstein, my wife's daughters. What are they doing?
Listen, children. I've been fighting all my life for this world. It never ends. They're gonna send everything they have at you. To survive, you have to embrace the suffering. To stand up and carry it. It's not about the pain you can deal. It's about how much you can take.
It's do or die, sis. Just like Papa taught us.
God, first Gears of War, now Wolfenstein. Fucking hell.
At Bethesda, we're proud of our history of innovation, and that includes breakthrough VR technology that we revealed at E3 2012. Since then, we've delivered some of the very best VR experiences in gaming, from Doom to Fallout 4 to Skyrim, and we're not done. Two of the franchises that we just heard about are going to also offer VR experiences. So, when Prey's Typhon Hunter is released later this summer, you'll be able to experience the competitive mode that Susan and Ricardo were just talking about in virtual reality. And it will also include a single-player experience that puts you in the boots of TransStar employees working to solve puzzles aboard the Talos 1 space station. I'm also excited to announce a new Wolfenstein VR game. It's called Wolfenstein Cyberpilot, in which you play a hacker who can take over Nazi robots and turn these war machines against their masters. In our ever-ending quest to bring the message of fuck Nazis to every platform possible. Both the Prey and Wolfenstein VR experiences are playable this week at our booth at E3, so please stop by and give them a try. Now, we are really excited about everything that we've shown here tonight, but I know there are a lot of you who are really here or really wondering about Fallout 76. And I'm pleased to tell you that your wait is finally over. Ladies and gentlemen, he is the recipient of numerous Lifetime Achievement and Hall of Fame awards. He's the game director at a studio that has won a bevy of accolades and awards. And he's here tonight to tell us what he and his team have been taking so damn long to tell us all about. Will you please welcome my very good friend, Mr. Todd Howard.
Looking good. Oh, it's great to be back at E3. Thank you. Thank you so much. I could not be more excited to be here. I want to thank all our fans who came out tonight. And the millions of you watching online. We can't thank you enough. This is actually my 25th year at Bethesda. And I have seen...
That's also how many centimeters tall he is. What a coincidence.
I've seen a lot of cool things in that time. I got to say, tonight is definitely, definitely one of them. I got to go to the very first E3 right here in Los Angeles. I know. They're so cute when they're little.
People say that to him all the time.
They're full of energy and life. And then, remember when little E3 ran away from home, went to Atlanta? Yes. A lot of you didn't come. I liked Atlanta. Or East Coast. And then E3 went through the moody teen years and came back and locked itself in its room. Remember, it was in the convention center, but just in the meeting rooms. They didn't invite anybody. And I can remember literally walking between the halls and seeing nobody. I was like, this is how a zombie movie starts. And now E3 has grown up, it's in its 20s, it's more confident, can handle its alcohol better, like all of you. Thank you. So there's a good party after this, so pace yourselves. And I hope you're comfortable, by the way. I'm gonna be here for a while. And E3 has become such an incredible week of entertainment, but we know that most of you came here for one thing.
Skyrim on
Thank you.
On another platform. That's what we're looking for.
I think it's to see where we're putting Skyrim next. Well, I think we have the best one yet.
The Elder Scrolls speak of the past and the future. Now, Skyrim looks to the future, to its ultimate version.
Alexa, play Skyrim.
You're level 57 and see a tall snowy mountain.
Climb it.
Now, Skyrim and life become one.
A mud crab scuttles towards
First
you.
Froda!
I didn't catch that.
First Froda!
I didn't quite catch that.
First Froda!
Your shout echoes all the way to Sovngarde.
What happened?
First Froda, that's the command for knocking things over.
Is there a command for picking shit up?
Haven't reached that level yet.
I'm sworn to carry your burdens.
Ooh.
The dragon unleashes fire breath on you.
Okay.
You have 7% health left.
Oh, shit. I drink a health potion.
You are out of health potions.
How many wheels of cheese do I have left?
473.
Okay, I eat all of the cheese.
Hey, hun. Remember what the doctor said about dairy?
Yes, right, yes, of course. You're the greatest. Thank you so much. I eat all of the cheese.
Introducing Skyrim, very special edition. Also coming soon to Etch-A-Sketch, Motorola Pagers,
oh, shit.
And your Samsung Smart Refrigerator.
Eastland Noose. Oh, that's cool.
Had to do it. Okay, really, we both know why you're here, and that's to talk about the next Fallout.
Fucking finally.
Fallout 76 is a prequel to all the other games, and it's our biggest one yet. It is 4 times the size of Fallout 4. Set in the hills of West Virginia, you are one of the first to emerge into an untamed and very different wasteland.
Years after our great nation began, we gather together to honor the completion of Vault 76. This sprawling underground shelter may have been engineered by Vault Tech, but it was built by you. So that if the bombs do come, our way of life will endure.
Almost heaven. West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is all there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, blowing like the breeze. Country roads, take me home.
For when the fighting has stopped and the fallout has settled, you must rebuild. Not just walls, not just buildings, but hearts and minds, and ultimately, America itself. In Vault 76, our future begins.
Vault 76, one of the very first vaults to open, was built to celebrate America's tercentenary, which is an awesome word, by the way. Like, that's your word of the night, tercentenary. You are one of the very special few selected to be an occupant and spend 25 years underground waiting for Reclamation Day, the day the vault opens.
Good morning, Vault 76. This is the Overseer. I hope you all enjoyed the party last night, even those who may have overindulged and overslept. But it's time to get up and get out there. We've been locked away long enough. Today is Reclamation Day.
Oh, finally! I feared you'd never wake up. Don't you remember? Time to leave the vault! Most of the others have already gone.
It may be time to leave, but I'll never forget the day you all entered Vault 76. You come from every walk of life, every race, color, and creed. But you all share one very important trait. You are this country's best and brightest. But more importantly, you'll always be my family.
Goodbye! Aloha! Ciao! Viva Reggie! Au revoir!
Here we go. Let's see how good... Oh, you fucking cocked these. All right, there we go.
We always start with the world, and this time it features all new rendering, lighting, and landscape technology. It allows us to have 16 times the detail and even view distant weather systems across the map. Now, most people don't know West Virginia that well. It is an incredible array of natural wonders, towns, and government secrets. This is where the actual nuclear secrets are. And the quest the Overseer sends you on will take you through 6 distinct regions, each with their own style, risks, and rewards. There's plenty of cool new Fallout creatures, and we even use the folklore of West Virginia to bring our Fallout versions to life.
Is that a fucking Ewok? What was that?
We have always wanted to tell that story of what it will be like for you and the other characters who were first to leave the vaults. But there is one big difference with this game. It's that each of those characters is a real person.
Who's laughing now?
Because yes, Fallout 76 is entirely online. Okay. I know there's a lot. You have like 1,000 questions right now. So I'm gonna go through them in order. Now, I'll hit a couple of the big ones. First, of course, you can play this solo. All right? You'll be who you want, exploring a huge world, doing quests, experiencing a story, and leveling up. We love those things about our games, too. It would not have it any other way. But also, like many of you, we have always wanted to see what our style of game could be with multiplayer. So many of us talk about experiences in our games, but we've never experienced them together. So about 4 years ago, we hit upon an idea that is perfect for Fallout. Open world, survival, every person and character is real. And it was an idea that we just couldn't shake. We knew we had to do it and do it in a really big way. Now, I know you may have played survival modes in like some of our previous games or some other online games, and we, you know, people wonder, is this hardcore survival? I like to think of it maybe it's more softcore survival. Maybe that should be a new ESRB descriptor. Death never means the loss of progression or the loss of your character. Your character isn't tied to one server. As a matter of fact, you'll never even see a server when you play. You'll be in a world with dozens, not hundreds and not thousands, of other players. It's the apocalypse. It's not an amusement park, okay? And you'll be able to join your friends whenever you want, and all of your progression goes with you.
What are you doing, Todd? What did we do to deserve this?
When we think about games...
Was it the short jokes?
We think about worlds.
Is this payback for calling you a midget?
And the choices that you can make. The stories that you create and tell yourself. By creating a wide open world with very few rules, we have a game more than any game that we've ever done where the choices are yours, where you'll decide what happens. You'll decide the heroes and you'll decide the villains. Look, this is a whole new world for all of us here. And fortunately, our friends at Vault-Tec have made a series of informational videos for when all of us emerge together.
How happy are you, Chat? Are you excited for Fallout Rust?
As you venture out into this new American frontier, some of your fellow survivors may not be neighborly. Chin up there, sport. Not all Vault 76 dwellers will be so hostile. Find them and brave the new world together. Whether you choose to explore the wasteland alone or with friends, your days will be filled with fun activities.
You can run like a rabbit, fly like a bee. No matter what you do, you'll never get away from me, because life behind you.
Like previous Fallouts, you can play this game solo in quest. But the easiest way to survive in the wasteland is to team up and build together. And in this one, you can build wherever you want. And you can also then move that to wherever you want.
After thermonuclear war, man's towering industrial marvels may no longer stretch to the heavens. What separates man from beast? It is his desire to build. Get started with CAPS. The Construction and Assembly Mobile Platform. Construct your home of the future. With your home secure, you can now craft handmade ordnance at your leisure to give your altercations that personal touch. It falls on you and the ingenuity of your fellows to rebuild the America we hold dear. But don't become too attached too quickly. Monitor your environment for anything out of the ordinary. The home of tomorrow may undergo certain challenges. After a crisis, work with your neighbors to ensure success. There's no I in nuclear wasteland. Document your adventures. Your memories will shape the new American dream. What's that sound? Oh dear. There goes the neighborhood.
You know, we love dynamic game systems. So we thought, why don't we put multiple nuclear missile sites on the map? And then let all of you do whatever you want with them.
Today's episode, Atomics for Peace. When you emerge from the comfort and safety of your vault, the world you know will have changed. Take your friendly old neighbor, Johnny. Rather than coming over to borrow a cup of
sugar, this is legit depressing.
Sugar,
I'm going to be honest with you.
He may now be coming
this
over.
This is actually a little worse than I was expecting.
Murder. The time has come to seek out greater means of protection. Nuclear armaments. That's right. Courtesy of your Uncle Sam, these wonders of the atomic age can be found right in your own backyard. But how does a fella like you acquire nuclear weapons, you may ask? Begin by inquiring with the locals. Gently coax them into cooperation. Use a little elbow grease if you have to. In the likely event you don't acquire a full code on your own, do not give up. Search for others who might be harboring a grudge. You'll have that nuclear launch code in no time. With the power of the atom at your fingertips, be responsible and consider your target carefully.
Attention. Launch sequence activated.
Is this real life? Like, what the fuck?
Will your bomb land on a rival camp of degenerates? A random stranger? The local wildlife? Whatever your target may be, take advantage of the resulting fallout to gather rare and valuable resources.
Well, how can there be an endgame in this if you can just nuke any location on the map? You're gonna fuck
yet
it up for
these
everybody.
These rewards don't come without risk.
Oh, this is fucking awful.
The fate of this new world is yours to command with the power of the atom.
We know you've played a lot of our games and a lot of online games, but this one really is unique. We have built a platform, 100% dedicated servers that will support this game now and for years to come. And look, look, we know this is new for all of you. It's new for us. It's a little bit scary. And to that end, we're going to need your help. Because, yes, we are going to have a beta. And it is sponsored by our friends at Vault-Tec as well, the Break It Early test application. Because evidently, these online games are hard, they can have some nasty issues. I read on the internet that our games have had a few bugs. I did, I read it on the internet, so it's true. And that sometimes it doesn't just work. Anyway, we know together that we are gonna build something really special. And we also know that all of you love our special editions, and we have an awesome collector's edition for you. It starts with a map of the world that glows in the fucking dark. And it's great. It's so cool. It comes with figures you can put on the map. And it also comes with a Fallout collectible that really I've always wanted, so we made them for everybody to buy, and here it is.
Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Ain't no use in diving. What's the use of diving? Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top.
Yes, all of this, the Fallout 76 Power Armor Edition. So you're probably wondering, when is this game coming out? We're excited to say that it's coming out this year, November 14th. Thanks again for all your support of Fallout. It's been 10 years since Fallout 3, our very first one, and it's been an incredible journey with all of you. We do have another Fallout anniversary that we are celebrating here at E3. It is the 3-year anniversary of Fallout Shelter, which we announced and released right here at E3. And we have some cool surprises for you. Fallout Shelter is coming
to the Switch. Come on.
PlayStation 4.
Oh, I was going to say the Switch. I was almost sure of it.
And because that guy said it, it's also coming to the Nintendo Switch.
Oh, you heard me. The little midget heard me.
You can play it with the Joy-Cons or touch controls. And yes, it's still free. And excited to say these versions are coming out tonight. Again, thank you so much for your support of all that we do coming here tonight. When we see how many of you our games have touched, it's incredibly special. Especially Fallout Shelter. That game has been played by over 120 million people. Incredible. That is more people than every game that we have made combined. Incredible. It does kind of make you stop and realize that our games can have new lives on any type of device or system. And you know, when we looked at the iPhone 11 years ago, we had a few ideas for mobile games. Fallout Shelter was one of them. And we did have another one that was far, far more ambitious. And we've been building it. And it's in the other franchise that you love from us. It is called The Elder Scrolls Blades.
What?
Like Fallout Shelter, we wanted an experience that we were not finding anywhere else. Here it is. Blades, at its heart, is a pure Elder Scrolls game. A massive first-person RPG with console-quality graphics, but with a uniquely mobile experience. Believe me when I say you have to see this running on an iPhone X. This gigantic screen does not do it justice. You can tap to move or use dual sticks. Combat is all new, and it follows your specific movements and timings.
This is so bad.
Harkening back to the first Elder Scrolls Arena, this game features both handcrafted and procedurally generated dungeons. And it's not just melee. You have a range of abilities and spells you can use. And of course, you can create your own character and be who you want to be. Improving them, leveling up, picking new abilities. And the entire game can be played in portrait mode. That one was incredibly important to us, that you could play it however you wanted. You never know when you'll need a free hand. To hold your coffee, what do you...
Or to hold the gun after you shoot yourself.
And it's not just dungeons. It's incredible outdoor areas. Yes, running on a phone. It really looks and plays incredible. Blaze has several modes of play. First, the Abyss, a roguelike experience where you can see how far you can go in an endless dungeon. And the Arena, where you will do battle one-on-one against other players. And the main mode, the Town. This is the hub for your story and quests. You are a member of the Blades, the Empire's top agents. Forced into exile, you return home to find your town destroyed and need to rebuild it. Yes, Blades also features a town building mode.
I think I need to write a letter to EA and apologize.
And be able to upgrade.
I'm changing their grade from an F to a D.
All of the individual elements in it. As your town levels
put things
up,
into perspective.
You unlock new NPCs, quests, and more. You can even visit your friends' towns. This is an Elder Scrolls game that you can play however and wherever you want. And we are going to bring Blades to every device and system we can. Phones, PCs, consoles, also virtual reality, on mobile, all the way up to high-end VR on PCs. And what's really cool is all of those connect to each other. So one of my dreams is we'll go back to that portrait mode, which I like to call meeting mode. Because if you're in a meeting on your playing a game...
He just won't fucking stop.
In portrait mode,
it's like he has
no
to pour salt in the wound.
You're playing a game. And so with Blades, you could be in a meeting playing Blades against someone at home in VR. Blades is coming this fall for free. And you can pre-order it tonight on both the Apple App Store and the Google Play Store. Also, this week, go to playblades.com and register for early access. If you're here at E3, Blades is going to be playable in our booth. So please, come by and check it out. You really need to see it running on the phone. We'd love to see you. Please come by. I just want to thank you all again, all of our fans here, everybody watching online, for all of your support over the years. It is so exciting to show you all that we have coming out this year, and it is an honor and a blessing to represent all of the incredible people at Bethesda Game Studios. We have 3 offices now in Maryland, Montreal, and Austin. There's a lot of them here tonight. I want them to hear your appreciation for their work. Just the best team and group of people I could ever hope for. Amazing. We also thought, since we're all here together tonight and it's so special, maybe we'd do something a little different too. And tell you what we have coming beyond this year in the future. We have also been working on a brand new next generation single player game. But this one is in an all new epic franchise. Our first wholly original franchise in 25 years. We're excited to announce our next adventure. Starfield is a game that we have spent years thinking about and working on. Something we feel uniquely positioned to pull off and that we're incredibly excited about. But we're also building toward the game after that. And it's the one you keep asking about.
Shit. Is he gonna redeem himself? I shouldn't get hyped. I shouldn't believe his lies, but I'm a little excited. That's right,
okay,
you clap
Ashley,
for the title screen.
I'm really done. I just want to thank you all for your time tonight, the time you've spent in our worlds. We'll see you out there.
Is it still going? Is there anything else that can be said? What is Pete Hines going to say? Is he offering them cyanide under their fucking seats for this shit?
We only get him up here like once every three E3s, but boy, when he shows up, he brings the goods. Thanks also to all of our studios and teams around the world who are so dedicated to giving our fans the very best games. If you're a gamer on any platform of any kind, we think we've got something for you. And I hope you're as excited about what you've seen tonight as we are, whether it's a new Fallout game, a new Elder Scrolls game from Bethesda Game Studios that you can play on your phone for free, Rage 2, Doom Eternal, and so much more. We're really excited. Now, remember, if you want to be one of the first to play Elder Scrolls Blades or join the Fallout 76 beta, you need to go to BethesdaNet and register. It's easy and it's free. For all of you here with us tonight, thank you so much for joining. The party is going to continue afterwards. For everyone else around the world, thank you so much for joining us. Everyone have a good night and a great E3.
Okay, well, oof. Fucking shit. Yeah, I need a minute. I'm going to be honest with you, chat. I need a minute. I have to grab a drink before we dive into this fucking atrocious show. But first, let me formally state, I am sorry, EA. I should not have shit on you as hard as I did. I thought you deserved an F. I've learned a fucking lesson. I've seen what an F looks like tonight. A giant F as an F you to the audience for what we just saw happen. So give me a minute. Let me get a drink. And we'll come back and we'll talk about what Bethesda just did. Because they just shit in our mouth. So I think it's interesting to talk about that. Try not to kill yourselves after the Fallout announcement. Just give me a minute. Where to begin on this fucking shit show, chat? This feels like Todd's revenge. All those years of shitting on him, calling him a liar, telling him he treated the mod community like shit, that his games were buggy, that they were whores and released their fucking games on every single platform that exists, all the hype jokes, telling Pete Hines he was terrible at his job. It felt like this is Todd's revenge. Like he did the things that everybody thought, please don't ever do it. And he put it into one fucking giant show. And then he came out on stage. And he just spit in your mouth. He spit in your mouth. And then he made you pay him for it. That's what it feels like. This clip actually now is actually now more relevant.
Who's laughing now?
Don't fuck with Todd, yo. I was excited, I guess, for Doom Infinite. Infinity Wars? I don't fucking know what the title was. Doom is fine. Doom will be great. I look forward to the Prey DLC because I actually like Prey. Everything else I had no interest in. Fucking mobile shit. Who cares about mobile shit? Rage 2 looks like a bunch of... It's a CG bullshit trailer. It's bullshots. It's not going to look like that on a fucking console. And I know the PC people out there are like, I can run it like that. I'd like to remind you what happened with Rage 1. Don't believe his lies. But that's not what we should be talking about, is it? We should be talking about what he just did to Fallout. This fucking Fallout Rust version. This Fallout Battle Royale version. Oh, it's only 12 people you're playing with online. You take your character everywhere. You won't even notice the servers. An online-only game like that, or an online-all-the-time game like that, you can kiss modding goodbye. I mean, how's that going to work? How's that going to integrate into a multiplayer experience? I mean, there's already a fucking paywall in the way. So that's dead. That scene's fucked. There can't be a story. There can't be any decent progression. If you have a mechanic built into a game where you can nuke any spot on the map, if you had an end game plan, something that was going to be, you know, the very finale before you went into sandbox mode completely, that's gone because you can just nuke it. Oh, is that where the final boss spawns? Is that where the final event happens? Just nuke it. Fuck everybody else playing the game with me. Jesus fucking Christ. Like, you know, people were saying, oh, it's going to fuck the lore up. Oh, yeah, it's going to fuck the lore up. Just, this was awful. This was, and then he gives us two fucking CG trailers that are 10 seconds long for two games that people actually were, you know, moderately interested in. They wanted to talk about Elder Scrolls and Starfield. No gameplay, no details. So, I mean, that obviously means it's not going to be a 2020. It's probably like 2021, 2022. So, this was really fucking bad. It was really bad. Yeah, a lot of people saying in chat, rip Fallout. Rip Fallout. Somebody said GameSpot is upset. I don't know why GameSpot would be upset. Well, you know what? I imagine everybody should be upset. It's just, Fallout was a fun fucking game. I know people don't, you know, they had their issues with the newer iterations. But it's so rare now to have a fucking single player game that you can enjoy. It's so fucking rare to have one that's just built with a giant world that you can go fuck around in and explore in and tackle at your own pace. And so to keep seeing them get knocked off one by one by one because all these developers see that their gimmicks and their trends that are raking in money, so they've got to shoehorn that in. They've got to take that IP and they've got to shove it right into that new trend. It's just really depressing. Fucking hell, man. Yeah, I'm a little fucked up over that one, chat. Yeah, I'm definitely changing EA score. Just from what I saw with Fallout, I'm rating this an F. And that's aside from the Doom and the Prey stuff, which I don't have a problem with, but the Fallout shit's an F. Maybe I'm alone on that. I don't know. But it is disheartening, to say the least. Somebody said Devolver started. Hey, you know what? This is going to be the end of my stream. I'm going to read off the Super Chats, talk a little bit. If you guys want to jump over and check out Devolver Digital is doing their stream, I'm sure it will be infinitely better than Bethesda's. Maybe wash the fucking disgusting taste out of your mouth and try to relax a little bit and forget this nightmare just took place. I don't know what their channel, I'm sure they've got a channel on YouTube. I'm sure you can find it on the hashtag on Twitter, but maybe go check them out. Read through some of these Super Chats, and then I'm going to go drink some fucking Clorox and prepare for tomorrow, hoping to God that Sony and the PC show and everybody else doesn't do worse than this. Just awful. All right, let me load this up. Cake Knight, low-key, this is all aimed at financially irresponsible teens who grew up on microtransactions and think playing Destiny makes them a hardcore gamer. You know, I don't disagree. It's a different demographic and a different market these days. And they're aiming for what they think is going to bring in the most revenue, which means a lot of people that grew up playing a different type of game are pretty much fucked. We get to watch the IPs that we really enjoy and associate good times with get raped. There's nothing we can do about it. Panda Pants, Jim Jones definitely now has competition with Todd Howard as a suicide influencer. Incredible. I don't disagree. Candyman, Interplay makes the best Fallout games. Dick Kilroy, the most hype I heard was for the glowing map. Yeah, I noticed that too. If you actually go back, not this stream because I talk over it occasionally, but if you go back and watch the raw footage of the Bethesda stream and you listen for the clapping and the cheering, it does not sync up with the audience. That was a total fucking cheer track. That's bullshit. They knew it wasn't going to be. And even at times, they didn't play it. There were points where Todd would say something or somebody else would say something, and it was just dead fucking silence. Quite amazing. Vault Dweller 604, at least we know Fallout players come from every race, color, and creed. Looks like I'll be playing New Vegas and Cyberpunk for a while. Well, Vault Dweller, remember, diversity is our strength. And when you get bored with New Vegas and Cyberpunk, don't forget you can play as BJ Blazkowicz's wife's daughters as they fight to liberate France from misogyny, or whatever the fucking storyline of that's going to be. Stevie Ray Vaughan's free helicopter rides. Jim, did you notice Todd had to initiate the collapse? My God, if only Yeb could behold the majesty. Can't wait for Doom Eternal or maybe Elder Scrolls 6. Yep, I'm sure Doom and Elder Scrolls will be good. I hope. Bow Wow. At least we know Starfield and Elder Scrolls 6 are in development. Very true. The Man in Black Fallout Recreational Nukes Edition. Amazing 1985. Will mods work with solo play in Fallout 76? I have no idea. I don't imagine it's going to be a pleasant experience. The Red Devil, are your balls as blue as mine from that Elder Scrolls 6 bullshit? Yes, they are. I wish they would have showed a little bit more than that. Kind of felt like they were maybe a little bit nervous about what they presented and wanted to throw something out to try to sate the bloodlust of the audience. Mega Killer X, I stayed up all night for this shit. That was a mistake on your part and a mistake on my part. And a mistake on the part of anybody that actually was looking forward to a good Fallout game. Weston Redwood thought EACC Mobile pounded my childhood's sweet butthole. But goddamn, or but GD me if Todd Howard, or if Todd found a way to screw it harder than using my own tears as lube. Yes, he fucked us all tonight. Connor Potoff, Jim, tell my friend Joseph he is a nigger. Well, there you go, Joseph. Double O, EA saved by grading curve. That is very true. The bell curve saved their ass. Jeremy Joestar, why does Pete look bored and disappointed like he would rather be anywhere else? But here he's talking about video games. And how buggy will the Elder Scrolls 6 be? Probably very. Frederick Godzilla Mencken, how you doing, Jim? Sekiro Shadows die twice. I felt like I died once tonight watching this unfold. It's illegal to possess those stolen documents. I want to believe the lies, those sweet, sweet little lies. Don't believe his lies. I heard at least 32 different lies coming from Todd. $10 too. With Fallout 76 being online, there won't be any mods for it. Even playing it solo, you're still going to connect to a server, and that means only approved mods from the marketplace will be allowed. Takasu, No Man's Starfield. Solomon 6 Million Wits. I can't wait for society to actually collapse after watching this. No more technological development in games. Cancel the summit. I want real Fallout. Jolly Rogers, Bilgewater, plus side is it can't get worse. Wait. I believe that's right before the shit show started. Kenneth, stop ruining Fallout, you cunts. It's supposed to be about meaningful choices, good writing, and real RPG mechanics, not herder co-op and build a cool gun. A little too late now. Nathaniel Esposito, Elder Scrolls Razor Blades. Because you're going to want to use them on your wrist after you play that mobile piece of shit. Retarded Genius, TH equals Justin Trudeau's gayer little brother, 100%. Zachary Carson, Todd is giving me an aneurysm. Paul Pauta, is this hell? I believe that maybe Dante missed one of the rings in the Inferno and we may be in it. Mace Dindu, why is Todd Howard so hellbent on desecrating Fallout? Why stop? It's already dead. Lord Akira, wake me up inside. Zeradart, online BS means little to no modding, which means a dead game within 6 months. Good job, Howard. Bethesda games die without mods. Midrian Emrys, sad to see my predictions were pretty dead on. I saw a lot of people speculating, actually, talking about that, that it was going to be a shit show. I just did not imagine that they would be pretty much correct. Paul Pauto, fuck you, Bethesda. At least I want to thank you. One, you gonna fuck me. So angry he couldn't get that out properly. I understand. It's all right. White Devil Man, I'm going to kill myself, Jim. Have a good one. Rest in peace. Nemesis Raccoon, boo. I need to get a boo button for this fucking shit. I should have had that ready. I should have had a boo sound clip ready to play when this got going. Massive Damage Gaming, funny how Todd Howard, the Ultimate Beta, wants to have this game have a beta. It is a bit of meta-commentary, is it not? Tiny Telephones, there are more people watching this stream than in-game on Wolfenstein. Laugh my ass off. That's because we bring the real diversity. This chat is the real diversity, when they all in unison start screaming that Todd Howard is a cunt. It's not diversity, that's unity. We're all unified in the fact that he just fucked us. Striker Quiet Amazing, I'm gonna fuck this up for so many people. I believe a lot of people are gonna be fucking up other people's games. Fallout 76 may end up having more of a troll audience than any kind of audience otherwise. Das Pooch, Fallout 76, lore is for faggots, retcon everything. Super Mutants in 2102, Skyrim Dragons, you name it, baby. Chris Hyde, you know they're going to sell resources to us for online use, right? Microtransactions, here we come. You may not be far off the mark with that comment, Chris. I do not have a good amount of hope for this. Castizo, the only redeemable feature is it has multiplayer in the building. I've always wanted a virtual ethnostate. Well, your dreams may have come true, but remember, there are only other, like, 12 or 14 people playing with you. So, it's not going to be a very big ethnostate. Anuta Shoa, don't watch E3 tomorrow. Turn on CNN. I'm on my way to their headquarters as we speak. Seriously, how are there super mutants 20 years after the Fallout? Because fuck lore. Fuck lore right in its ass, that's how. Candyman, FO76 is an ANCAP simulator. Confirmed. Tony Cannoli, Battle Royale with cheese. Lord Akira, I wish I had access to multiple nuclear launch sites to end this fucking shit show once and for all. Avery Chambers, what is bad about this? I don't understand. Well, Avery, when you hit 18, you know, 6 years from now, we'll have this conversation. Hackerism 1, Fallout 88 patch 1.4 won't let you have a shade of skin lighter than a chalkboard. Fuck Battlefield 3, or I'm sorry, fuck BE3, fuck diversity. Paul Pato, I hurt myself tonight, and Anarcho Monarchist, I'm actually okay with this, so long as I can still play alone. My concern is that the online features are so driven into what this game is going to be, that playing it alone is going to be some kind of wonky, fucked up version. Maybe it will be okay alone, I really don't know. Pinky Culture, Ethnostate, and Fallout, please. Jolly Rogers, Bilgewater, It's Dead Jim. Blue Satoshi, so this is how they're going to drop mod support with online. You know, maybe you're not that far off the mark, I'll be honest with you. Blue M&M, did we just get cucked? Yes, we did. R. Jeffrey 14, Jim, if you played Doom 2016, I'll buy it for you. No need to buy it for me, I have played it. James Russell, Jesus fucking Christ, why? There are a lot of people that seem pretty fucked up over this. I don't blame any of you. Nerdbane, you need a O&A car crash on that soundboard. Yes, I do. Malcolm from the North, Skyrim R. Bud Dwyer edition, coming soon. Each bullet is a choice, like accept Lydia and join the Dark Brotherhood. Use the trigger to eject your choices into your dome place. Or into your dome piece. Sean Turner, they better put Skyrim on the fucking GameSphere, the best version that could have possibly been exclusive. Nemesis Raccoon, a good day to die. Yeah, this has been one hell of a conference. I Run Assault. Can't wait to play the new Wolfenstein DLC co-op with my wife's son while I enjoy my refreshing Soylent. Fuck Drumpf. And fuck white people. Double O. These propagandists don't care about sales. That's not where the money comes from. And we've got one from Joe Masters 575. Ma fuck Nazis. Fuck Drumpf. Respect women. Yeah, there's been a heavy theme of respecting women. I've noticed that from EA onwards. EA, Microsoft, and this have been very diverse. Diversity is our strength, and they've really gone the full nine with that. Bethesda tonight talking about diversity and creativity and all that shit, and now we've got BJ's twin daughters fighting in France. Blue Satoshi, hey Bethesda, the war ended 73 years ago. It's time to move on. No one cares or should care anymore. Rocker Boy, notice how all the cheering is about talking or. Notice how all the cheering is about taking to the streets against Nazis. California Antifa libtard much. They aren't even cheering for Wolfenstein. I did not catch that, but I bet you're probably right. Go back and listen. Nemesis Raccoon, couldn't even get a full room of applause for 76? No, they could not. Tiny Telephones, why do all these people think it's 1945? Fucking get over it. Trolita Kekistania, Hitler did nothing wrong. Lord Akira, fuck Nazis. 1599, respect women. Das Pooch, well, apparently Bethesda didn't learn from the abysmal sales in response to Wolfenstein SJW edition, and they're doubling down. Can't wait to see this one's sales figures, lol. Now, I did play Wolfenstein 2, whatever the fuck the subtitle is, I don't know. But my issue with that was, it felt like you got 10 minutes of gameplay, and then 2 hours of cutscenes. And that drove me fucking crazy. You'd play the game, and then you'd have to run around the little base and then watch a bunch of cutscenes, and then you get 10 minutes of gameplay. And after about like 2 hours of that, I said, fuck it, and I never played it again. So I didn't have hope for it anyway. This just adds on top of that. Wolfenstein Young Thoughts Edition from The Highwaymen. Dan Corita, Wolfenstein, The Feminization. Nemesis Raccoon, Whatcha Gonna Do, Youngblood. Striker Quiet coming next year, but no footage promises. Iron Snarksis, Worse Than EA. Yeah, I agree with you on that. Paul Poyita, End Me Please for the Love of God, Amazing 1985, Terabad. Reckon Sarah, Those Who Aren't Fat and Buff Douchebags, Those Who Aren't Fat and Buff Douchebags Are Soy Boys. Isn't that right? Lol, I'm not insecure about possibly being called that insult, too. All of the chat. Well, chat, they just dunked on your ass. That was from Rekka and Sarah. Nemesis Raccoon, dear God, a new Wolfenstein game. Just off me now. Hashtag resist. Turtle Poop, Eurotrash is always trying to empower women. Successful wheelchair technician, this game made me hate black people. It's quite the reaction. Lord Akira, can we get a 1488 in the chat? Hippo Talks, what's your opinion on League of Legends? Also, hello from Canada, where misgendering is a crime. Well, I will try not to misgender anybody and get you arrested for, I don't know, conspiracy to commit a crime. My opinion, I don't play it. I'm not really into ass faggots games. I've never really been into them. Professor Worthless, Prop Hunt Deathmatch DLC for Prey. Gray Fox 37, that chick on the Prey showcase is on her third adolescence. Classical positioning, not a mimic, a diversity quota. Lord Akira, Pete Hines is a wife beater. You heard it here first. Lord Akira breaking the hot breaking news for us. Hopefully that shows up on Kotaku. And he can give a full interview with all the juicy details. September Clues, love your live streams. Thanks for streaming. Glad you enjoyed them. Nemesis Raccoon, who has the bigger T-breast, him or his wife? Fuck you, Google. Why can't they just, you know, show gameplay and gameplay trailers? See, and that's why I gave Microsoft, a nice solid C. They didn't really, I mean, there were a few moments that dragged, and maybe I got a little too upset about that. But Microsoft was pretty solid. I mean, you can argue about the premier status of a lot of it. You can argue about the exclusivity of it. But they showed off fucking games. They took 2 hours and they showed off a bunch of fucking game trailers. So kudos to them. They know how to put on an E3 show, unlike fucking Bethesda. Misty Spillers, I normally would not watch Bethesda, but between Mr. Medeker's commentary in the chat, this has been pretty funny. Have some more shekels. D. Joseph, E3 2019 to be canceled due to lack of enthusiasm. Whatever they put in the water at the audience at the Bethesda show, hopefully that doesn't spread to other shows because people are going to be narcoleptic and sleeping through the presentations. Holy Onimusha. It's like watching Jeb Bush all over again. Nemesis Raccoon, Smash Brothers is the original. Battle Royale, Blue Satoshi, it's called Eternal because the ride never ends. You could be very right. It's very clever. Candyman, unexpected features. I bet they mean fucking Doom Battle Royale. Mark my words. I don't know if I could handle it. How many games can they fuck into the ground? Lord Akira, who let Takasa out of his wheelchair? Crackpot, Elder Scrolls needs to feature large anime tits for Steam. Cindy Coles, GS and VC forever, as blessed by Mr. Medeker, thanks. Power Cage, it looks like we found Yeb's true destiny, working at Bethesda. And Goaty McPimp, I got this money by jerking some dude off at a house party, and I was going to use it to buy a ride home, but a friend ended up driving me. Saw your stream up and immediately knew where I'd spend it. Well, thank you for the handy $10. Goaty McPimp. Looks like a few more came through while I was reading those. Let me refresh here, go through, talk to you a little bit, chat, and then, like I said, I'm going to go drink Clorox and prepare for tomorrow and hope it's not as bad as what I just witnessed. Fucking hell. You know what? I bet it will be. I bet it'll be a bunch of episodic content, DLC, and just all sorts of fucking shit that's just going to make people miserable. Benito Mussolini. This year's E3 is why death camps were invented. Terry J. Hi, I'm Jim, and I think Hitler did some things wrong. Robert Chuck Wolfenstein. Yes. Robert Chalk, Wolfenstein, Aunt Flo's Revenge. Elizabeth Bathory, Punch Nazis, Get Wrecked Pole. Nemesis Raccoon, can you tell Nathan and John I'm drunk again? Nathan and John, Nemesis Raccoon is drunk again. Right, Am, the one game I still played ruined. Thanks, Todd. Yeah, Todd fucking hates everybody. Robert Crawford, feel better, Jim. Use his money to buy a beer. Things need to get worse now so we can race war for a better tomorrow. 13th King 13, I'm on the fence about Fallout 76, Jim. Play it by ear, I guess. You know, if you think it's going to appeal to you, go play it. But I'm kind of pissed off about the direction it's going, and I'm used to Todd lying out of his ass about everything. And I think it's going to be broken and wonky and not as pleasant as people are imagining. Jeffrey McLean, could be worse. Imagine Atari VCS exclusives. Just wait. It's coming. Universal Impurity. I heard Todd just got exposed by the Me Too movement for brutally raping Fallout against her will. It might be in the hashtag now. Killer Queen, Todd misses the mark once again. We wanted a co-op Elder Scrolls game, not an Elder Scrolls MMO. We wanted a co-op Fallout game, not a Rust Fallout game. When will they get a fucking clue? Well, considering how long it took him to get the joke about porting Skyrim everywhere, I'm going to say about another 4 or 5 years. So enjoy that. Roker Boy, watch the Devolver Digital stream, you motherfucker. I think that's where the majority went. We had about 14, 15,000 watching. We're about half of that now. Again, I'm sure the Devolver Digital stream will fix some things. Put you in a better mood. A Roker Boy, Devolver Digital. Taily Bones, maybe Elder Scrolls Blades will be will be on the Ouya. Or are you trying to say Ouya or the Ouija board? Because most of the player base is probably going to kill themselves. Problematic White Knight, 1980 NSDAP Paris is better than 2018 Shit Scandiland, capital of France. Wasser USCA, I'm going to shitpost, but Fallout 76 looks so bad it killed the enthusiasm. Welcome to the realization that it's pretty fucking awful. Alec Majorson, will Bethesda have a problem with me writing whites only in neon all over my settlement buildings? I think they will, but you can test that theory and it'll probably make a funny video. Shmezzy, get ready to be killed by 12-year-olds with bad mics while playing Quest. That's probably going to be a feature. Bow Wow, Just Cause 4 will be the only single-player game. That is a fucking terrifying thought. Bow Wow. Son of Tiamat, I've been waiting years for a new Elder Scrolls game, and all I got was some lousy teaser trailer. What a cock tease. Yeah, it kind of sucked, I'll be honest. Kaiser Squishy, what gun should I use to kill myself? Whatever's convenient for you, Kaiser. CS, yeah, let's improve all the building mechanics and allow people to build anywhere, and then allow 12-year-olds to nuke fucking anywhere on the map. Bethesda. Not really thinking that through, were they? Caps Lock 3, I can't wait to explore Fallout 76, riddled with dick statues. It's coming. Anarcho-Marnarchist, what issue specifically did you have with Fallout 76? I think the implementation of this online feature into gameplay is going to fuck up even the attempt at making an endgame. It's going to make it almost just it's going to be gather resources, build shit, but there's really no point to it because we don't have a story to drive you anywhere. We'll give you a few side quests, but there's nothing major for you to do because some fucking 11-year-old can just nuke that NPC. An 11-year-old can fuck up that event area. And so you're screwed out of a real story. That would be one of my biggest issues. Cake Knight, low-key, this is all aimed at... Oh, okay. And that's where we go. I'll double check for any others, and then we're going to call it a night. Call it a night. Again, thank you all. This has been E3's Bethesda stream. Tomorrow there's Sony, the PC Gaming Show, Ubisoft, and I'm missing one. I can't think on the... My brain is fried from this experience, so I can't actually tell you who I'm missing, but there are four of them. And I'll have the times up and the stream up ahead of time. Okay, hit these last ones. The Clown Storm, have $5 to buy a beer and try to forget this happened. Edmund Ploppy, what kind of faggot needs friends in their game? AGK, are you streaming tomorrow too? Also, Jim's real name is Herschel Leibowitz Goldenberg Stein. And from R. Jeffrey 14, here's some money for a calendar so you can keep a schedule, you lazy nigger. Also, when's tomorrow's stream? You know what? I'll tell you right now. I'll pull it up right now if I can find it, and I'll tell you the start time of the stream tomorrow. And then I can tell you who's on it, because I forgot one of them. So tomorrow it's going to start at 12:30 p.m. Eastern. And it's Squaresoft first, then Ubisoft, followed by the PC gaming show, and finally Sony at night. So those will be the four. I'm just going to stream one continuous block. It'll be about 6-7 hours, so you can pop in and out for whatever appeals to you. Generally, the PC gaming show is kind of slow, but I like watching it. I feel bad for the guy that hosts it. He tries his best. But yeah, so 12:30 p.m. tomorrow, Eastern Standard Time. Okay, last two, and then I'm out. Garrich, do you prefer Lemon Fresh or Spring Meadow for your bleach consumption purposes? I prefer whatever is handy. And finally, Millie. Hey, Jim, it's real funny to profit off the poor victims of a school shooter, eh? Bet you wouldn't have the time if he shot Jade. Well, she can't get shot. She's in a fucking cage in a cornfield. But thank you for the $5, Millie. All right, stream tomorrow will be at 12:30. Again, it covers the four that I mentioned, Squaresoft, Ubisoft, Sony, and the PC gaming show. Have a good evening. Go check out Devolver Digital. Probably good shit over there. And, can I get an F? Can you put up an F for Fallout? Can we all remember and just hold true to the memories? Resting in our heart-ripping pepperoni Fallout? All right. Have a good evening.